Hello, this is Chris. Welcome to the Aviation Video on Flight Sim. We are in San Francisco today. Yay! And yeah, we're in the quality wings today and we're going up to Heathrow. Pretty fun? Yes, pretty fun and pretty long flight. And guess what, guys? Here's a nice fun surprise for you all. The plane's all ready to go. You guys don't have to sit through a very long waiting thing. That had nothing to do with me forgetting to plug in my microphone. Nothing to do with that for that bit of the flight. That's not why we're skipping it. I'm trying to respect the viewer and not show you guys the boring, useless bit.
Officer and I push start proof off taxi.
Totally. And now pushback is broken. Okay, we need to redo it. Okay.
Miles from Diet. Maintain 4,000 till tower clear for the ILS runway 2LX.
British Airways isn't even part of Alliance, but I don't, it's kind of weird pushing a BA plane back with United.
1 o'clock and 1 miles.
Okay, yeah. But yeah, we're going up.
Visual approach runway
20. Yeah. We're going up to Heathrow today. 9.5 hour flight. I'll kind of show you guys what's going on. You guys might be able to hear my dog dying in the background. That's not a very pleasant sound. But yeah, that's the plan for today. We're going to Heathrow. I'll get you guys all briefed on the flight on the taxi, but we need to get out of here. And I had a connection issue, so my PDC's gone, but I have my squawk in, so that's all good.
1-2-2-3-4 in Arkham Bridge, that's approved.
There's a big kind of, I hesitate to say big, but here, you can see there's kind of a group flight kind of coming into San Francisco, which is where we are right now. So it might be a little bit busy. Just keep that in mind.
United 76, expedite the descent down to 4,000. Once reaching, reduce speed to 20 knots or less.
Yeah, so that'll be fun. Oh, my dog is dead. Anywho, yeah, we're moving.
76. Get down first and then float a 220 knots or less. Thank you.
This will be a nice short one for you guys, even though this is going to be very long for me. Right. Just kidding. I get to sleep through the whole thing. Okay, we can start up now. This actually might be a way to start the videos in the future. This actually, you know, it might actually be something I do in the future. This is a pretty good method of doing things.
American 37, welcome to San Francisco.
Now you guys don't have to deal with the boring bit, and it's really not that much of a plus for me. Maybe you guys will watch more of the video. Look at that. Rex is very good at what they do. You know what they say. X-Plane looks better, except for the shaders. That's not what they say. No one says that because nobody plays Flight Sim. Fun fact. Yeah, so we're moving. I guess that's pretty obvious. Today we are
at 876 turn right, heading 120.
Yeah, I'll talk to you guys on the taxi because it's a fairly long taxi. We're going all the way out and around Bravo. Here, I'll show you guys quick. We're right here and we need to go all the way out to 28 left. And that engine's probably on.
Up 214 North Hill approach, leaving descend via the Bodega 3 arrival. Expect the ILS runway 28 right approach. And Foxtrot.
Waiting your confirmation for good engines. And we're waiting for 20 on the N1. Which is right there. So yeah, it's a pretty long taxi. I'll tell you guys what's going on. The short story is we're going to Heathrow. And it's going to take a while. And ATC is very loud. I'm gonna turn ATC down a bit. I should probably double check the ATIS, mainly because I don't really have any version of altimeter set, which is 3001. And that's basically started, so I'll confirm so they can get out of here. FedEx, whatever. Hey, don't disconnect my parking brake. Have I broken GSX? Okay, this is one of those ones where you... Oh yeah, this does it where the emergency lights, even though they are, say, armed, they don't actually... Is GSX doing its thing? Oh, it is. Okay, good. Sometimes it would break when that happens. I don't want this thing, because this thing is a joke.
Yeah, it's 76, 725, 0 intercept.
And we are supposed to be, according to our PDC, which I no longer have access to, because I had a connection issue. I had to reconnect, but it says I'm supposed to be going and hold short of Bravo and then contact tower, or it's only departure on, but you know, get the idea. We have engines on, so that can happen. That's not on. I don't know why that's not on.
214, fly heading 100.
Recall and flap 15.
Delta 214, make it a 105 heading on.
We want to go. Systems, flight control, we want to go ups and downs, we want to go lefts, and we want to go rights. Beautiful.
One right, taxi the Alpha Alpha 1.
We can go weather radar on. Have a good trip, we're cleared to go. Can move forward. And we want to be trimming, actually I should bring that back up. I forget.
Delta 800 at Eddie clear.
We want to go into 6.25. So my trim button is messed up on my yoke. Because if I do that, I've accidentally bound it to. Wait, are we working? To not trim. So, as you can see. Oh, wait, no, it's working. Is it going to trim me, though? It made the sound.
Delta 800, clear to Eilish runway 2A left bridge.
Yeah, it's not trimming me. So in short, I have to like keep it. We're about in the taxi. So we're supposed to contact ATC short of Bravo. And we have info Foxtrot. We're departing in 28 left today. Because that's where the heavies depart. Because it's a long runway. The other ones are pretty short and the heavies can't make it.
29. Welcome to San Francisco. Exit left, Bravo departing. Have a great night.
Hey, there's a United 777.
Yeah, 876.
You know, as much as Captain Sim is a ripoff, I kind of want their 767. I just like, oh my dog is. I've said it five times now. But. Yeah, I might want to get that. I might want to invest some of my monies. I probably won't because the new flight sim is coming out. Yeah. Okay, where does Bravo start? Bravo starts like. There, so I have a ways to kind of move. Unless, see, this is a tricky bit because I really don't want to screw this up. If I screw this up, let's just say you don't want to screw this up. I could just make this turn and then say we're approaching Bravo. Yeah, I'll do that.
Delta 214, turn right, heading 120.
Of course. And just as I. Okay. Good evening, San Francisco. SP Bird 6, Bravo Heavy is approaching Bravo, and we'll get the nudies in a second. We're ready to taxi.
Okay, everyone that can hear NorCal, contact NorCal 133.95.
Okay.
23-22 North approach, good evening. Descending the Vegas 3, check the ILS runway 2 left approach. Golf just became current.
That's interesting. We were told to go to 1205 on the PDC, but. Oh well. Oh, I bet Bravo starts right there.
ILS 2 left.
Okay, now I can call him. Evening, NorCal, SPBird 6 Bravo is approaching Bravo, and we're ready to taxi, and we're getting the new Edis now.
SPBird 6 Bravo, runway 2 left, taxi via Alpha Foxtrot. Actually, make it Bravo Foxtrot, hold short 1 left.
Bravo Foxtrot, hold short 1 left, SPBird 6 Bravo heavy. Okay, so Bravo Foxtrot, that is going to be, I know it's going.
1807.
Bravo. Okay, that's not what I expected, but yeah.
Whiskey, Bravo, and Ram. Have a great day. Delta 214, turn right heading.
Am I on Alpha? Yeah, right. I need to get over to Bravo. Turn see, I'm right so used to this. Nothing to see here. This is still concrete, technically. We just overshot the turn. What are you talking about? I didn't go the wrong way. To be honest, it's a little confusing. To be fair, I should say.
Left 809, runway 1 right, line up away, traffic landing 28.
I want to see this traffic landing. See if he booters the bread. Even though everyone seems to completely forget how to land when I'm watching them. Maybe it's the pressure because I'm such a celebrity with 15 subscribers. Where's the recall? Wow, I lost the recall for a second. Flight control and ground equipment and flaps are set. Okay, I need to worry about my trim now.
Southwest 162, clearance over cross standby.
No, wrong one. We are not doing flap 17. See, it's late. It's one. It's past one in the morning. Oh, that guy is already landed. Might be another guy coming in. Okay, so Bravo, see, because I want to turn here, but that's not Bravo. This is Bravo. It's actually kind of obvious, but as we all know, I am stupid. Speaking of stupid, does anyone remember the last time that we flew this aircraft on the channel? It involved me pointing my phone at the screen.
Delta 800, maintain one.
That is one of my, second most viewed video. Why? I don't know.
Delta 800, 180 knots, please.
See how slowly it moves up? I don't know if you guys can even see it, because YouTube ruins videos. Ish. Up to 4.5. Am I not hitting it anymore? See, I really should be looking where I'm going. Oh, there we go. And I want to see this next guy land, so I want to be able to look up in a second here. Click, 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 click. There's an easier way to do this trimming. Let me know.
Delta 214, third try. Traffic 11 o'clock, 1 mile. You're overtaking them for the left, descending to 3,100.
Okay, trim is kind of important, so here, I'll use this opportunity while we very, very slowly move this up. We are British Airways flight number 286 today, going to Heathrow from San Francisco. Second time featuring San Francisco on the channel. First time was a horrible video with terrible production value, entitled Huge Quality Update. So that's kind of something. It's kind of some drama going on up there. But yeah, that was a horrible video in which I thought I was recording properly, but I was actually managed to mess it up in post. Usually you fix things in post. I screw things up in post. So what? Oh, hello, United.
Speedbird 6, Bravo Heavy, cross 1 left, hold short 1 right.
Cross 1 left, hold short 1 right, Speedbird 6, Bravo Heavy. Is there anyone else on the approach? Have I missed all the landings?
Delta
yeah, there is.
Turn right heading 100.
There's Delta 800 and then the other Delta 100 that's 100 screwing 100 everything up. Yeah, so it's going to be 9.5 hours in the air today. Once we get across the runway, it's kind of just a straight shot to our runway. So then I'll show you guys our routing today. But one thing that's funny is that Simbrief says 9 hours 32 minutes in the air.
Bravo Heavy, cross runway 1 right.
Cross 1 right, 6 Bravo, thanks. Let's see. There he goes. Goodbye, Alaskan. You know, another thing, P3D has, like, miles better model matching. Like, look at that. That is beautiful. X-Pilot, everything's all in the ground and looks weird and... Yeah, weird. Anywho, yeah, so basically, here, let's get some lights turned on here.
This 131 NorCal approach, descend via the Bodega 3 arrival. Foxtrot is current.
One of these. Not that. That. See the plane coming in there? That. Okay, we're clear. So, yeah, here's our route today, folks.
Push start your discretion, talk to taxi break.
Here's our sim brief. Here to Heathrow. Not in the mood to divert, because guess who doesn't have any scenery for there? Me. So it'd be ugly and default and not where I want to go. But we do have the Aerosoft at Heathrow, so that'll be nice. Kind of required if you're flying British Airways to Heathrow. Here's our route, 9 hours 32. Yeah, which instead, it's kind of weird because I did this flight a few days ago and it took me over 10 hours. So I don't know if winds or routes or something's weird, but this is where we're going off of the Sentina to Orca, and then we're going to be in via Bobbington, probably. That's kind of the plan. We have a lot of fuel. Hopefully we don't run out. If we run out, we'll just die. That's unfortunate, but here we go. This guy's landing. That's our plan for today. Let's see. I don't know if I want to look in. Let's see. This guy better put up a good show. That's the only one I get to watch.
1, 2, 2, 3, 4. No traffic between you and Salinas. Radar service is terminated.
Come on. More flare. Ew. Yeah, that was okay. He got her down. And now I'm falling off the runway. Or the taxiway. He got him down.
2322 maintain 4000.
Kind of looked like he was coming in slow. Okay, I don't know why there's a minimum. We don't need that. Can I reset and get rid of it? Yeah.
2322 maintain 4000.
Please be. I don't know what's wrong with my shadow there, but.
Okay. 6 Bravo Heavy. Runway 28 left, flap away.
I'm going to put you 28 left, shooter. 6 Bravo Heavy.
Delta 800, taxi
park. Okay, sorry, but I always have to make sure I'm transmitting because my yoke has a tendency, the thing, I have the honeycomb, and it has a tendency, one of the thing that connects the yoke to the main control thing, the main column, it has a tendency to not plug in right, so sometimes it'll kind of fall out and my buttons will stop working, and I don't like that because then I'll think I'm transmitting and I'm not. And I have, like, my look around here on it, and it's really annoying when it breaks. But
23, 22, reduce speed 220 knots or less, turn left heading 330.
Look at that, and water is better in P3D. Another thing. I like both simulators equally well, just saying. Get that out of the way. I've only started playing X-Plane in the last, like, year and a half, so I'm much more experienced with P3D and FSX for the longest time, so... Why is that still there? I thought I...
American 2322, I can barely hear you. Reduce speed 230 knots or less.
Hey, this guy's also going to... Oh, that's probably that United.
Turn left heading 330.
Okay. We used a lot of runway to line up there, but... Oh, well, we're here. And, that guy is having issues. Everyone's having issues today. That's how I find flying late at night like this. Like it's 1:20 a.m. for me, and I'm Central Time.
Delta 214.
But everyone is either incredibly stupid or everyone is just having a good time. So it's either the best time on VATSIM or just the stupidest time on VATSIM. So.
Delta 214, maintain 2000. And are you re-intercepting?
That's kind of the thing with night, and you know.
214.
See?
Try this. Airport 12 o'clock and 10 miles. Do you have it in sight?
Now you're good.
There are clouds here, Delta 214.
Delta 214. Well, you're going to have to intercept the localizer. You're going to have the airport one or the other.
What is that? 100? Is that?
2322. Fly heading 310. Maintain 3000.
Is there someone taking off? I'm never gonna get going here, am I? Yeah, this is pretty fun, isn't it?
Delta 214, are you established?
I think I have visual here, Delta 214.
Delta 214, clear visual runway 2 right approach. Break.
Look at that.
6 Bravo Heavy, clear for takeoff 2A left.
Clear takeoff 2A left, shooter 6 Bravo Heavy, thank you. No, okay, that's off. Okay,
Delta
we're. Let's go, shall we?
4,000, fly heading 100.
50, and we take off at a very low thrust setting in the 787.
Fly heading 100.
Okay, there we go. We're going. Look at that. 75.4. All right, nose forward. Airspeed's left. But it's a long runway. 80 knots.
Perfect.
100. Keep that center line. We gotta accelerate here. End of the runway's gonna, we're like halfway down it. We can start getting into the other side touchdown zone. It's fine. This is a really long runway. Rotate. We're up. Welcome to the sky. Positive rake, you're up. A little steep on the pitch. We were pitched a little, or trimmed a little too high there. It's okay. We can kind of pitch it down a bit.
Alaska 809, contact Oakland Center, 125.85 tonight.
Beauty. Okay. We're flying. We're getting a pretty good climb rate too, considering we're, you know, going on a 9.5 hour flight. I don't like how much the sun is kind of sticking out, but oh well. You know, I think it's also weird that that planes are allowed to like fly over this like hill thing at SFO.
2322 runway 28 left clear to land.
Because I know if you're in like a 747, you kind of have to, you know, do the turn. Because I don't know if you can safely outclimb it. But I guess in a Dreamliner, they expect you to be able to do it on this departure. Or I don't know if that's the reason, but... It's actually very unusual for it to be busy. And you guys know that. This busy on a, you know, 1 a.m. Why am I...
Contact Oakland Center... 125.85.
That wasn't me, I don't think. Alright. I'm going to keep it in manual control for a while, because why not?
585 Norcal Bridge, good evening. Descend via the surfer arrival, expect the ILS 28 left, Fox Tracker.
Okay, we are going to do 250, because that is a restriction. I don't know why it wants us to be above that, but
Delta 131, reduce speed, 230 knots or less.
Hey, Golden Gate Bridge, okay.
Turn left, heading
I just want to see the Golden Gate Bridge. Let's see, any good views? I have no good views. So I could go into this view.
That's Bravo Heavy, NorCal departure radar contact. Climb maintain flight level 190.
Climb maintain flight level 190, SP Bird, 6 Bravo Heavy.
Open mic.
Rip, yeah, see.
Anyone else looking for
because my thing got, it unplugged there for a second and it,
hold short of 28 left for Delta 214.
It, yeah, it wouldn't unkey there, so, see? This is annoying. Anywho, we're flying. I'm going to VNAV. Everything seems to be working here. There, oh, look at that. Ooh, thumbnail. That is a thumbnail, if I have ever seen one. Wait, if I go like that. Oh my, that is the gorge. The gorge, that is, oh my gosh, what am I?
Receiver 6 Bravo Heavy, clear direct Orca.
Clear direct Orca, 6 Bravo Heavy, thanks.
Delta 131, looks like you might have gone through the localizer. If you need, correct back to a 260 heading.
Alright, cool. That helped a little.
Southwest 2162, runway 30 right, clear.
Good stuff.
Clear of takeoff, 2162, southwest.
Ooh, we have some night lighting, which you don't really want to be looking at because it's horrible in P3D. Even the... I only have the default Orbex. Oh, how far you can zoom out. This is... And this guy should probably get terrain on, shouldn't he? And traffic.
Delta 131 NorCal.
See, it was pretty busy, wasn't it? Okay. Oh.
Delta 131 NorCal.
I think I've definitely found my thumbnail. Okay. We're through 10K now. V-Fly-10s, I don't know. That's not even doing... Oh, there we go. Okay, yeah. Should probably do that.
Delta 131, NorCal.
Yeah, I think I'll let you guys go, and I'll see you guys when we get closer to Heathrow. It'll be 9 hours. I'll be going to sleep. And
copy, NorCal?
We'll...
Copy.
We'll,
Copy.
And then we'll have a... Yeah, we'll see you guys later.
Super 6 Bravo Heavy, contact Oakland Center 125.85, good night.
Oakland 2585, Super 6 Bravo Heavy, good night. Did it break again? No, okay.
Super 6 Bravo Heavy, contact Oakland Center 132.85, or correction, contact Oakland Center 125.85.
Alright, yeah, we got the 12585, or 8 for Oakland Center Intruder 6, Bravo. Good day. Yeah, see? It doesn't work. I need to make sure it's plugged in.
NorCal approach, fabulous, 469.
Yeah, so let's check in with this guy, then I'll let you guys go. Because, I'm tired. We're all tired. This is why I check. This really annoys me. This yoke isn't even a year old, and it's all... messing up, and my dog is having a spaz attack. Why is this guy so quiet? Okay. You know what? I'll let you guys go now. See ya! Hello, everybody. Welcome back. We're back. And we're going to start descending soon into Heathrow. We got about 20 miles to go until top of drop, so we should probably throw in our arrival. Wind at Heathrow today at 260 at 11, which means 27 right, because I believe 27 left is broken. And Bobbington 1 Bravo is what we're planning. We are going to have London control. Yes, there is a London control on. And there's a Heathrow Tower, so we'll have some pretty good ATC on the way down. Yeah, so that means our descent's now in 40 miles because we kind of have to go to a downwind. But yeah, that's the plan. We're making really great time. We've been flying for 8 hours, 51 minutes. Oh, we don't want that. So if we get down in the next 30 minutes, which is, I think, probably going to happen, we will have made it in maybe 10, 15 minutes early. So that's pretty good. Got some really nice tailwinds. We've stepped up to 390 for our final. I don't know why it is high like that, but hopefully it fixes itself. It's that one. Because it is not nighttime. There are some pretty nice views out the night when we were kind of flying over the US. That goes to 2000. Yeah, it was pretty neat. I would have showed you guys, but too lazy, remember? I'm a very, very lazy person. Okay, that's good. Here, I'll go into plan mode for you guys. Plan. And we can just... Huh. That's not what I want. I don't know you could do that. Clear. Here. I'll just do the way that I know how to do it. Wait, can I just hit desk? Yeah, here's what we want. Okay, so... What we do is you basically come around here to Bobbington, and then it's ATC vector from here to the ILS. It's usually pretty good. London has some pretty fantastic air traffic controllers, or just the UK in general. So we should expect to get in pretty well. It's usually like 8,000 feet around here is when we turn in, so... Yeah, we can grab the ATIS at Heathrow. That's the wrong ATIS. Yep, arrival 27 right. 27 left is on. Like, it was... Last time I flew into Heathrow, it wasn't... They weren't landing and departing on it. It was turned off. Or... Closed. That's the word I wanted. Okay, information Bravo, arrival runway 278. Transition level is level 70. This is something I really don't get about the Boeings. Is why my transition is in the forecast page. Can I request? Does that work on the quality wings? Doesn't look like it. They usually have a little that thing there if I can't request it. Oh well. Maybe it'll populate later. 70, I'll pull up a chart of Heathrow for you guys. So we can have a look at where we're landing. Stand by. Oh, would you look at that? London Control wants me to talk to them. 127.1. Okay, I'll go say hi to those guys, and then I'll... Then I'll come talk to you guys about our arrival. Or, yeah. Okay, London 127.1, 127.1. Good afternoon, London Control, P3Dv4, 6 Bravo, level 390.
P3Dv4, 6 Bravo, London, Squawk 4673, Bovington 1 Bravo.
Okay, Squawk 4673, and it's going to be the Bovington 1 Bravo for P3Dv4, 6 Bravo. Okay, so that's what we planned for, Bovington 1 Bravo. So we're going to come in that way, around to Bovington.
26 Bravo, descent level 330.
Descent level 330, Speedbird 6 Bravo heavy. Okay, almost said heavy.
6, 3, 8, Montezuma, 1, 2, 2, goodbye. 1, 2, 2, 6, 3.
Okay, so we're going down to 330.
Stop the climb for now, level 340.
So that's a little bit earlier descent, but, yeah.
2E88, stop climb platform 340.
Here. It's not wanting to go down.
Ryanair 7 Delta Hotel contact. At 1, 2,
here's what we'll do.
Bye.
Bonjour, 3-8, Ryanair 7 Delta Hotel, thanks for showing the light.
330. No? Yep, there we go, we're going down.
London Control, Speedbird 276, request descent.
Very silly here, we'll help it.
Flight level 220, Speedbird 276.
Okay, that'll help it. Anywho. Yeah, let's do 1,000 for the initial. Oh, wrong button. Okay, so here's our chart. We want the fives. We'll probably park here or here. And this is our... Here's a better view. Here's 27 right. So we'll probably do auto brake minimum. Because you kind of want to get out Alpha 10 Echo or Alpha 11. So we will probably use... let's see what the speeds are. We'll do 159 and then auto brake low. That should be a good speed. Yep, and then we'll be able to get off in time. If you don't make Alpha 10 Echo, Alpha 11 is after that, so that'll be good. We can do the descent checklist, recall. Good. And then we'll deal with that on the approach. Okay. Seatbelts on. We can increase that descent rate a little bit. Okay, folks. We're coming in. Hopefully nice and early. I'm going to talk to you guys when you get a little bit closer because I don't think you guys want to watch us come all the way down from 370. So I will spare you the boredom and talk to you guys when we get a bit closer to Heathrow. Hello, we're back. And we need to start slowing down to 240. We're clear down to 80, coming into Bobbington. We're going to go kind of on a downwind. There's Heathrow right there. This is a nice approach because we get to kind of fly around the city and stuff. So that's pretty nice. That. Not until crossing 80, mate. Okay, we can kind of level out here. So it can help slow down. Help it on its way, because we're still pretty low-ish. And the 787 can slow down pretty nicely. Check the lights on. Look at this. London is always a really nice place to fly into. Really nice place. So big. And it's not on any coastlines, which is when Orbix Global looks horrible, so yeah. That's if I ever get another product for P3D, it'll likely 122.8 Tudor 6 Bravo. Good day. Huh? Didn't expect that. So next is gonna be Heathrow Tower 1.85. I thought we'd have him all the way in. Here, let's do that. Wait, is there a Heathrow Tower? Oh, no, there's not a Heathrow Tower anymore. Oh, well. I guess they're going 1228 all the way in. That's fine. This could be interesting. Heading hold. See, that's it. I've never used that. I've always wondered when that would be useful. Let's do... Yeah, this is actually a good heading right now, present heading. Okay, can ascend down to 3,000. Autogen's still taking a minute to load in, but it'll, you know, it's doing it. We should be level changing at 240. That's a good height. Heathrow traffic, Speedbird 6 Bravo is on a right downwind for 27 right. Okay, I don't know if that's proper phraseology in the UK, but it's what I'm saying. This is going to be a beautiful CDA. Yep, we're coming down right about where we want to be. And then failed to aircraft. Interesting. That guy's taxiing. Everyone seems to be doing their job. Yeah, it might be about 9:25, so only get in like 8 minutes early. Oh well. Well, this is actually probably the quickest we could have possibly gotten in. So we're definitely a little bit high, but you know, we can descend pretty quickly. I don't know what that airport is. It's really close to Heathrow though. See, this looks nice. This is really nice. London looks nice in P3D. So yeah. Okay, we're looking good here. We are below 8. I should have known that. What's the QNH? 1016. So that'll get us even higher. 1.6. Okay, checklist. That's done. So then it's just a landing checklist, and we can deal with that when we land. Okay, I do want to use flap 1, but flap 1 you drop like instantly. So, yeah, let's do it. Flap 1. We can bug to the flap 1 bug. And we also want to keep the VS in. Cool. And I forgot to set our minimums. And 200 is good radio because it's not very hilly here. So, see, look how quickly we're dropping. Here we can do a little less than that. And we can go flat 5 if we wanted to as well. Which I think we will. Flaps 5.
Ladies and gentlemen, in preparation for landing, please return all CTACs and tray tables to their upright and stow position. Ensure all portable electronic devices are turned off and stow all.
Okay, let's turn in. Heathrow traffic, Speedbird at 6 Bravo, making right turn, heading 200 for the base leg, Heathrow. Okay, we are starting to get closer to the ILS, so we can kind of bring the descent rate in, and we can go to the flat 5 bug.
Heathrow traffic, Speedbird 982, Golf taxiing Alpha, holding point November, Bravo 3, runway 27, right.
And Heathrow traffic, Speedbird at 6 Bravo is continuing the right turn, hitting 230 to intercept the ILS 27 right. We're going to be on a 10-mile final. Okay, I don't know why we're adding thrust right now.
Heathrow traffic, Speedbird 4 Delta Charlie, taxiing via Alpha Bravo for 27 left.
Let's try that. Yeah, we got to get down here. Localizer, and someone said they were taxiing to 27 right, which is interesting. Okay, we're coming in pretty good, if just a little bit fast, but that's okay. We can just dial that in. So we got to kind of keep coming down here if we're going to intercept. Coming in a little bit kind of on a short final, but that's okay. There's no ATC, so we can kind of do stuff like that. We should be getting the localizer here. I don't know why we're not. There it is. Approach. Glide slope. Okay, we are fully established. Check. Okay, we can select flat 15. Go down to the flat 15 bug. Alright, good stuff. Kind of overshot that a little bit, but oh well. Heathrow traffic, Speedbird 6 Bravo, fully established. 6.5 mile final, 27 rate. Okay, gear down. Get the rest of the lights on. Don't know why the seatbelt sign's not on. Okay, and then when we have the green light for the gear, which we do, we can select flaps 20. Beautiful. Let's see.
Landing checklist.
There is no traffic. Hopefully it stays that way. Okay, we're about 4 miles out now. We can fully configure 159. Oh, whoops. Flaps 25. There you go. Heathrow traffic 306 Bravo, 3 mile final 27 right. Heathrow traffic. Okay. Arm the speed brake. Wait, did I just disarm it? There we go. Rip. Okay, landing checklist is complete. We are all set to go. My aircraft. Alright, gotta get a nice butter. Yeah. Alright, got a straight headwind, so no excuses. Sorry for that sound of the yoke. One of my things is kind of loose on it, so you might hear that clicking sound. Do apologize. See, there it is. We are stable, by the way, through 500. Continue. Welcome down. First is green, gently lower the nose. Perfect. Auto brake is working. Alright, it looks like we're not going to make 10 echo, so we'll make the next one. Okay, manual brakes, 360 knots. And still the reversers. Okay, welcome to Heathrow.
Heathrow traffic, UPS 2455, pushing back and taxiing the runway 27 left by Sierra.
And we can go straight ahead, because that's where the heavies park. Good stuff. Heathrow traffic, T-Bird 6 Bravo is clear of 27 right, taxiing to stand, Heathrow. Okay, and I think these are like the 5-6s, so let's do like, let's do something like 5-5-6-8 seems like a good stand. Hopefully that's right at the end there. Good stuff. That's all done. Nope, that's what I'm here for, is the APU. Okay.
Heathrow traffic, speedbird 982, Golf, holding short 27 left, number 2 for departure.
Okay, we made it. And the landing rate was, moment of truth, 132. That's pretty good. That was a little bit of a long landing, but it was a good landing. Ish. Yeah, it was good. Okay, and this is us way down here at the end. Doesn't look like we get a jetway, but that's fine. Can set that to 100 and 3000, which is set. We can get rid of the weather radar so we don't blind anybody or radiate anybody with radiation. Looks like there is a BA320 going out. And I think this is us. 567, which is what we chose, right?
If there's traffic,
568.
Delta Charlie holding short to 27 left, number 3 for departure.
Oh, it seems like they got a bit of a line form in there. Okay, you can turn the lights off so we don't blind the ground crew. Okay, make the turn in. Okay. Here we are, 568. I don't know where our marshaller guy is, but we'll just follow that sign. To the right, okay. Keep on going to the right, and stop. I think we're off to the left, or to the right of the gate, but... Yeah, oh no. Yeah, a little bit. We're parked to the 767.
B4 Delta Charlie is lining up 27 left behind.
I guess there is no 787. Oh well. We're here, everybody. I'm going to complete the Freedom Project fly. I'm not going to turn out the engines. Okay, there goes Fat Sim. I'm not going to turn off the engines because that messes with the replay. As we all know, replay is the most important part of any flight. So let's do the replay, shall we? That was 9 hours, 26 minutes. So, yeah. Pretty good. Let's get the replay going. Chase Plane has a fantastic replay feature that we will use to... And it's a... Yeah. Stand by, folks. Okay, let's have a look at this thing. It's not quite as... streamlined as X-Plane, but you guys can kind of get a feel for it. We can look at some wing views and stuff like that. I did flare just ever so slightly too high. So, yeah, what can you do? Idle. And there's the hold, float. And on the ground. Okay, let's have a look at... Let's have a look at the tower view. See, it's kind of weird, but, you know, you get the idea. Yeah. Over the runway. There goes the power. And then there we go. Look at that. That looks beautiful. Oh, yeah. That looks incredible from the tower view. That looks absolutely incredible. Not to, like, toot my own horn, but... Better than last video's landing, which was just Float City. I mean, this one's pretty floaty, too. Gotta stop floating. No. Here, we'll watch one more wing view, and then we'll watch another outside view, and then we'll call it. Sound like a plan? Look at that. That looks so nice. Not a nice X plane, but still pretty nice. That wing. Beautiful wing on the Dreamliner. Here we go. I feel like the 787 idles higher than I would like it to. It's like 30 feet they cut power. I don't know if that's a real thing or a quality wings thing, but I'm pretty sure the 777 cuts at 20. Who knows? He still did a good landing. Okay. This might not work as intended. Yeah. I have to keep resetting the speed brake because it's kind of weird. But here, this isn't as good. Here, I bet I could see. Look at that. That could be a thumbnail if the gear wasn't all weird. And then. Floatity float. Coming in nice and gently kissing the ground. Ooh. Yeah. I'll take that. Alright, with that, I'm going to call it, everybody. So, I'm going to thank you guys all very much for watching. See you next time. Please rate or comment to this video. Once again, thank you for watching. See you next time. And bye.